Welcome to AskExcyte. I'm Tim Bushnell with Expert Cytometry, and today's question comes from Rick. And Rick asks, what are some of the strategies you use when gating? Now that's a great question, because I see gating in two steps. The first step is kind of a strategy where you're eliminating things that are caused, artifacts that are caused because of the instrumentation. That leads us to using a viability dye or dump channel to get rid of dead cells, cells that we don't want. From there, we go into our secondary analysis, and that becomes where we gate using the antibodies to define the populations we're interested in. This is where the FMO controls might come into play. So here's an example. I start off here with this first gate, which is a time gate. So I look at time versus scatter parameter to make sure I had an even in flow. I will use that gate to eliminate things at either end which might have been problems, or if there's discontinuity within the population, I can take that out by a gating strategy. There's some automated software that will do that for you you might want to look into as well. From that, I move to the second gate, which is my pulse geometry gate. This is using the power of the pulse geometry, area versus height, to identify the doublets versus singlets. We expect our single cells to lie on the diagonal. From there, I go to what I affectionately call the Schmutz Gate. This is the forward side scatter gate that most people will define lymphocytes and things on. I use it to eliminate small punctate stuff on the left side of the axis and things that are off scale. I'm not going to use this to define my populations of interest, lymphocytes or anything like that, because I'm going to use my antibodies to do that, because those are much more accurate and precise because they're labeling what I want to label. From there, I go to use my viability and or dump channel, and I'll put them in the same panel if possible as shown here, and that allows me to find the cells that I'm interested in. That gets rid of things that are dead, that gets rid of things that I don't want, the dump channel. And now I go into my detailed analysis using my antibodies. I'll start with my primary antibodies. In this example, I'm using CD3, and I plot CD3 versus scatter to identify my CD3 cells. From there, I go to my CD4 versus CD8, for example, and from there I would then go into my rarer event population shown here, along with my FMO controls over there. So that's kind of the way I develop strategies, starting again to get rid of things that are caused by the instrument and then use my antibodies to do the heavy lifting. Remember, if you have more questions, go to getflowtraining.com to learn more. If you have questions, you can also send them to me here at AskExcyte@expertcytometry.com. Thanks for another AskExcyte. Until next time, be sure to keep up with your best practices in flow cytometry right here with me, Tim, and Team Excyte.